What's up, guys? This is gonna be another review for the Ultimate Fighter fights, and this was the second fight that was shown last week, I think. Yeah. So this was Joanne Calderwood versus Emily Kagan, which you guys already know. They called Joanne JoJo. So yeah, let's get started on this review. So the fight starts, and you know, JoJo starts out pretty aggressive, you know, throwing some really nice leg kicks at Emily, and she was really you know, pressuring her and keeping Emily against the cage. So pretty much she was keeping that octagon control, and you know, Emily just kept on circling and stuff, but you know, she wasn't doing too much. But you know, eventually she started landing these really nice left hands that kept on catching JoJo. Like, she kept leaning in, and Emily would just reach in and keep on hitting her with that left hand. So that was something good that Emily did during the fight. But as you know, the fight keeps progressing and stuff. About halfway through the round, JoJo is, you know, still pushing Emily against the cage and whatnot. But you know, like I'm saying, she keeps on getting hit by that left hand. And then when there's about like 2 minutes left, you know, JoJo throws a really nice combo with a nice knee and like a straight right, which is a really nice combo. And of course, it connects. And eventually, a little bit after that, Emily gets JoJo on the cage and, you know, clinches and starts throwing, you know, some really nice strikes. But, you know, they're not really like heavy strikes, but, you know, still throwing some strikes. About 1 minute left, they separate and they continue to fight, you know, on the feet for a bit. But then Emily gets JoJo against the cage again, and then all of a sudden, you know, 30 seconds later, JoJo reverses the position and throws a knee, and then they separate once again, and then JoJo pressures Emily, you know, pressured Emily the whole round. So, you know, she easily won this round, and also on the damage too, she landed way more strikes. So I don't know if anybody else had the scoring different, but for me, JoJo easily dominated that round. And then we start with the round two now. So Emily starts off with a really nice left hand again, as she was doing in the first round, except she actually catches JoJo first before JoJo lands anything, I think. And you know, but then, you know, JoJo again, you know, keeps on getting pressured, Emily keeps on getting pressured by JoJo, and then they start getting each other against the cage again, like in the other round. And then JoJo maintains this this clinch, you know, against the cage, and you know, actually takes Emily down, which, you know, JoJo is not really known as a ground fighter, she's more of a striker, so that's kind of weird, but you know, why not? If you have the opportunity, go ahead and take him down to the ground. Eventually JoJo gets side control on her and, you know, lands some shots and whatnot. And about 3 minutes left, JoJo goes for a Kimura, you know, around right there when they're on the side control and stuff, to get to this weird position and stuff. But, you know, Emily reverses the position and, you know, takes JoJo down. But then again, JoJo gets a good position again on her, even though she's on the ground and stuff, and has like a lock on Emily. But, you know, at this point, this is where the fight gets weird. There's about like 2 minutes and... like 2 minutes left of the whole, you know, the round or whatever, the whole fight, I guess. And they're like in this weird north and south, you know, position and stuff, where Emily had like her ass on JoJo's face, pretty much the rest of the round, you know. It was kind of weird. Emily was on top though. So Emily was on top and JoJo was on bottom. You know, JoJo just had her face, you know, against her ass or whatever, pretty much the rest of that round. Emily was on top though, like I said, and you know, she was landing some strikes, but like barely anything, and she pretty much barely did any damage at all. I mean, really just tapping the body and stuff. So this round was very close, you know. I mean, it depends how you want to score. If you're basing the round off, you know, damage and stuff like that, then JoJo easily won it because she did more damage in the beginning of the round and stuff. But I mean, if there's some people, you know, that favor the, you know, people on top of each other and stuff like that, like the lay and pray type of shit. But that was not like a lay and pray. That was just like a Like, I don't know, like, Emily was just on top of her, and she wasn't really doing much. It was just kind of weird, you know? And the referee didn't stand it up either. I mean, I guess he was liking the view when when she was down, you know, like, maybe she just, they were just looking at the ass. Like, here's one of the positions right here, as you can see on this slide. That weird position. But yeah, that was kind of, like, weird that, you know, the referee didn't separate them. I mean, there were 2 minutes, they were just doing that, this north and south position, not... I mean, both of them weren't doing much, but, you know, JoJo wasn't even taking really any damage at all, and Emily was barely landing any strikes. So I don't see why they didn't just separate, or, I don't know, man. I think they could have done something to make the fight a little bit more exciting right there at the end. But, yeah, anyways, I gave that round to JoJo, though, of course, even though it was close. I thought, you know, the beginning of that second round, and how she took Emily down, attempted a Kimura, you know, before she took her down, she was landing some strikes too and stuff, and she was pressuring Emily again, so she had full octagon control and stuff, you know. So I thought, you know, JoJo easily won the round, but, you know, if the judges give it to Emily, then, you know, that would have been a nice third round, you know, like, why not? Would have been a nice longer fight, but yeah, I think JoJo won it. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much my review of the fight. It was an okay fight. It wasn't better than the first fight. I mean, that's for sure. The first fight was way better. This fight was like okay. I thought JoJo could have done more. I mean, she did pretty much everything right. It just Emily just let herself get pressured against the cage and just counter punching with that left hand over and over again. And they would get into the cage and clinch every now and then also. So I mean, the fight wasn't too exciting. It was an okay fight. It wasn't boring, but, you know, it was just an okay fight. Now, would I watch it again? Probably not. But I watched the Tisha Torres fight again. Yeah, I probably would. It was way better than this fight. That was a good upset also. Emily, you know, didn't come through on this upset. She didn't, I think if she would have been aggressive, probably would have worked out a lot better. But, you know, people have their own fighting styles and whatnot. So yeah, guys, I think that's pretty much all I got to talk about. You know, I'm really waiting for the Ultimate Fighter to start up again on Wednesday, and, you know, I'm also gonna review that fight. Hopefully, I review it that same day. I mean, I don't want to wait, you know, a couple of days and then do the video like this video. I should have done this one earlier. But yeah, I'm hoping to do a review on that video also. I mean, on the video on that fight, which is Jessica Penny against I forgot who it was. I think it was like Lisa something, or yeah, I forgot. I need to check that. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna do a review on that fight also. And like I said, I'm gonna be doing reviews on all the fights on the Ultimate Fighter. You know, all the ones that they're gonna show, I'm gonna go ahead and do reviews on them. Cause, you know, just cause why not? So yeah, guys, go ahead and subscribe, like, comment, you know, whatever. But yeah, I'll see you guys later.